Hey everybody, welcome to episode 5 of Karate Corner.
Today we're going to watch one of my all-time favorite Steven Seagal movies, Under Siege, directed by Andrew Davis. Now this movie is great for many reasons, but the masses also seem to agree because this is the only Seagal movie certified fresh on Rotten Tomatoes. It's also the only Seagal movie to ever receive an Academy Award nomination. Though it didn't win, that's still something considering none of his movies have that. It's also, sadly, a movie without the iconic ponytail because he plays somebody in the Navy, and the Navy doesn't allow ponytails, so we can't have it here. Now, this movie has famously been called Die Hard on a Boat because it is essentially the plot of Die Hard, and we'll get into that in a bit. But despite that, I don't take that as criticism because I love Die Hard and I love Steven Seagal, so I think this is going to be a good movie. He also has awesome co-stars in this movie. He's got Tommy Lee Jones, he's got Gary Busey, Patrick O'Neill, David McKnight. It's like a legitimate movie with a real cast and a real budget. Don't get used to this in Steven Seagal's career because we do go downhill somewhat quickly. That's about right. But for now, let's just sit back and enjoy a relatively awesome movie. So in this movie, Steven Seagal plays a guy by Casey Ryback, who is just a chef. No need to be alarmed. He's just a chef. He can't kick everybody's ass or anything or totally disarm entire groups of men. No.
Just a lowly, lowly cook.
So Casey's informed that tomorrow is the captain's birthday. And for his birthday, they're going to throw a surprise party.
A surprise party.
So don't tell the captain or anybody important if we fly a bunch of strangers onto the boat with zero background checks. It's for the party, so don't ruin this, okay?
Well, that was cute.
And of course, Gary Busey's character is in on it, because he can't play a likable character in any movie. Gary, no. Don't you take this out on him. I insulted you, not Steven. Don't take this out on his chili.
It smells like a lard omelet.
Gary. Gary, stop. Okay. Ah, you done it now.
Stop striking him.
Sorry, Steven. That's on me, buddy. I pushed his buttons. That's my fault.
Okay, all right.
So due to my reckless insulting of Gary Busey, Steven Seagal gets locked in a freezer.
He is an extreme psychopath. No one is to speak to him. No one is to let him out.
I can't help feeling like this is somehow Meg's fault.
Now we're introduced to, I think, the only female in the whole movie, Erica Aleniak. She plays Jordan Tate, who's a Playboy bunny, but in this movie they just use her as like a stripper. And fun fact, Steven Seagal suggested she be in the movie. They didn't actually have this character written into the plot at all. And Steve Seagal said, wouldn't it be great if there was a stripper who was my sidekick? You know, for comedy.
It's science.
We're also introduced to Tommy Lee Jones, who plays William Stranick. And I only ever think of him with, like, Men in Black, but the amount of energy he brings to this role is awesome.
Oh, no, sir. What do you want us to be? Over here?
I didn't know he was capable of having this much energy, to be honest with you.
Music is my life.
You over there.
Over here?
Starboard side, right now.
So the party gets going, and, yep, that's Gary Busey. Adam Sandler would be so proud of you.
The only reason he brought me on this cruise is for some Pacino-related shenanigans.
Gary, look at me. You're not well, okay? I shouldn't have insulted you earlier. I'm sorry.
I'm your date tonight, Captain.
No, Gary. Don't do that. Don't. Gary, you need help. I'll even take you to a psychiatrist, okay?
Do I look like I need a psychological evaluation?
Honestly? Yeah. Okay, while Gary's at the doctor, let's catch up the plot. So Gary, Tommy Lee Jones, the band, these guys, they're all in on it. And Seagal hears the shots and he's like, something's going on, call the bridge.
Something's going on, call the bridge.
And this guy's like, nah. And these bad guys get super excited. They're like, yes, we get a rappel. And then they rappel down to their own people and they're like, we meant to do that. Yeah, still cool. And we get one of my favorite cliches from this era, which is, if you're a bad guy, you have to eat like a complete barbarian. And we learn what Joe Pesci does when he's not picking on Kevin McAllister.
Where the hell did you take your shoes off?
Why the hell are you dressed like a chicken?
God, you're just so little and cute. They even act like the wet bandits. What are you shooting at? Huh? What are you shooting at? Do you have something against dairy? Are you taking your anger out on food? To nobody's surprise, they're no match for Seagal, who gets away. Shocker.
He's a little cranky. We just broke out of prison a few days ago.
Shut up, Marv!
So we learned that Stranick used to be an undercover agent who got burned, and he stole this ship to take revenge on the military, and he hopes that the way he acts, they'll just think that he's crazy or something.
If you believe I'm crazy, probably paranoid, something like that.
So Seagal keeps searching for some bad guys, and we run into Cake, and oh, right. Yeah, I totally forgot she was in this movie. Hey, thanks for showing up, I guess. So we learned that the plan is to offload a bunch of missiles onto this sub, and then they're going to sell the missiles to the highest bidder. They're also super cute because they use Looney Tune names as code names.
Mimi.
Meanwhile, Seagal has an internal conflict on what to do with the stripper.
No!
He's like, you managed to sit in that cake for like an hour. You can stand in a locker for a little bit, right? But who are we kidding? Seagal asks for this character specifically. Of course she's coming along.
Okay, you're coming with me. You gotta be invisible. If you walk by a hatch and you see the enemy, you become the hatch.
Speed up, speed up, speed up!
I'm gonna give you this assault rifle. It's an MP5. There's a selector switch on it.
Slow down, slow down, slow down!
You're not a cook.
Wait, what? He's not just a cook? Quick, Steven, say something really, really cool.
I also cook.
Come on, dude, you blew it.
The folks.
Annoying! No!
Can somebody seriously stop giving him weapons? He's gonna hurt himself. So while they're going through the ship, they hear some knocking through a door, and they realize that some of his buddies are stuck in there. Man, shoot, if only you had, like, an arc welder or... Yeah, no. Yep, that makes sense. I knew you had that.
Just as I suspected.
So him and the boys learn that they locked up the rest of the crew. They plan on drowning them to kind of lure Seagal out. And a couple of them are reluctant.
I cut out for this hero bullshit.
But thankfully, Steven Seagal's got a rally speech.
You're in the Navy, remember? It's not a job, it's an adventure.
Or an invitation to play Dungeons and Dragons.
Let's do it.
Oh, okay, it worked. This guy asked for help.
Show me how to work this week.
And Barbie's like, yeah, it's easy. You point the gun directly at your own stomach. And he's like, okay, I'm pretty sure that's not how you do it, but thanks. So the actual military finally gets a hold of these people and asks the only question we've all been wondering.
What the hell is going on there?
But Seagal doesn't have time to talk, because he's about to face the mustache triplets. We have me, Donnie Mustache. No, Donnie, it's me, Johnny Mustache. No, Donnie, Johnny, it's me, Lonnie Mustache. And their father, who's a Navy SEAL, catches wind and he goes, it's a cold day in hell when you have to kill your own kids. But it looks like me, Ronnie Mustache, will have to do just that. And they say, not so fast. We already have three of this guy. We can't have four. Oh yeah, and while a whole lineage is getting wiped out Genghis Khan style, the submarine shows up. I forgot this movie sort of had a plot. So Seagal finally decides to save the day, and he says, fine, I'll use my super chef knowledge to save the day real quick. Because everybody knows you just drill into a missile, put it over some hot water, put a grenade in a clamp, remove its pin. Pretty standard stuff. Hey, my sidekick's pretty hot. Let me show you how to put a condom on. I do it like this. I'm sorry, I distract. Condom was part of the plan. I wrap it in tape, obvi. Get a big wire going. Our missile's almost ready to eat, so I'll pour some honey out of it. Put the leftovers in my backpack. Put that condom on there for later, you know, wink, wink. Just scale this chain. This is totally me, not a stunt double. See, look up close shot. See, it's me. Quick swim. Oh, they see me. That's annoying. Good thing my gun works in water somehow. Got one. Okay, put the bomb here. Yep, all right, that should do it, right? Like I said, standard stuff.
Just a lowly, lowly cook.
And Busey tries to get the submarine going. And well, well, well. Would you look at that, Joker? Turns out they were quadruplets. It's, Connie, bad man.
This guy's a pain in the ass.
Okay, I forgot he showed up a fourth time, and only so many names rhyme. Give me a break. And the good guys watch the bad guys get away in a submarine, and sadly, all is lost. Oh, wait, no, except you're still on a battleship with guns, right?
You see those?
Just use the big gun on them.
Find the hole!
Yeah, okay, that was easy. Mission accomplished, I guess? Oh, wait, no, there's still Tommy Lee Jones. Okay, go get him. So he catches up with Tommy Lee Jones, and they play a rousing game of Simon Says.
Turn around.
Step forward.
Turn around.
Step forward. Have a seat over there.
Put your feet up. Relax.
But Seagal's been playing Simon Says for like 52 years. He passes with flying colors.
You are really good.
And Seagal says, okay, my turn. We're going to play a little game I call World's Longest Knife Fight. Then it ends the only way Steven Seagal knows how, by biting the knife blade side and pulling Tommy Lee Jones's eye out. Of course that's how it ends. Oh, but what about that missile Tommy Lee Jones fired? Can you guys take care of that real quick?
Roger.
Awesome. Oh, what about the people drowning? oh, great. Yeah, that was convenient too. Great. And everything wraps up into a nice, neat little bow, and the Playboy Bunny becomes a member of the Navy, because that's how movies work. In the Navy, yes, you can sail the seven seas. In the Navy. And there we have it, folks. That was Under Siege. The next movie in this series is called On Deadly Ground, which the short description on IMDb says a mystical martial artist slash environmental agent takes on a ruthless oil corporation. So I'm sure it's going to be a good one. Thanks again for watching. I'm really glad you guys are enjoying this series. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It really does mean a lot. And as always, stay happy, stay healthy. In the Navy, come